In this class, we are going to be going over how to use and edit a financial statement report. So first, we're going to go into the Reports Center and click on Financial Reports. We're going to be using the Balance Sheet Condensed. So first, we want to come in here to edit the balance sheet, and we're going to duplicate it. This is a standard report, so we want to make sure we don't overwrite it. So let's just call it this. Okay, now you can see the new report right here. So we're going to come in here and edit the revised balance sheet. And we're going to adjust a few things over here. So I'm going to go through some of these tabs on the left. So let's click on rows. And how this balance sheet is laid out is in summarized format, so an account group level of current assets, fixed assets, etc. So let's say you want to see a more detailed balance sheet. You click in the detail level here where it says summary, and you can expand by dimension here. The only thing really in here is summary height accounts, for example, on this one. So let's say we want to, we have some locations in this company. So let's say we want to do some different levels of detail with the locations under this current asset account group. So I'm going to run these different levels and show you what it does here. So the one level down with roll up, what that will do will, if you have locations and then you have maybe sublocations underneath it, so let's just say that you have a states and then you have cities underneath that. What that will do will just roll down to the state level, for example. Okay, so let's just preview this. So now I'm one level down. And now you can see the locational level, which I'll go over here and show you how the locations are set up. So the locational level, the parent, is this column right here in the locations part of the system. Okay. So basically, when I go back here, I'm going to rerun this with a little more detail. Let's go down to all levels with rollup. And the rollup means it summarizes it into a summary total. Now you can see Timberline General Construction has the various cities here. Okay. You can see the different ones right here. So if they have balances, you see there's quarry here under Timberline General Construction, and they don't show up, but if they have balances, they're showing up here. Okay. So same with Timberline Residential. We come over here and look at, there's different cities here. Okay. Okay. So let's go back in here and let's pick this one here, all levels with individual balance. So you notice it didn't mention anything about rollup in here. So what that does is it lists out the detailed level, the bottom detail level, and then totals it at that current asset level. Okay. So in the rows and the detail levels, you can come in here and play with the different dimension details and preview it easily over here on the live report and see how it shows and if that's the correct level that you'd like. Okay. Now, a couple other things on here. This column here, if you click this little question mark, if you click the box in here, it's going to show all of the accounts in current assets if they have a balance or not. So I'll show you here. So now it lists the zero balance items that weren't shown before. Okay. Now, one last thing I wanted to show you on this tab. Let's say you wanted to add some more account groups to the left here. So you want to click Select Account Groups. And you can come in here and see what's available. So let's say maybe for some reason you want to put that on there. You can just click there, hit OK. Now it shows up at the bottom. Okay. So you can play with the rows pretty easily in here. Functionality is really in the help menu and the structure. This is really easy to use. So I'm going to take that off easily by coming back in here and hitting the delete button. Okay, now we were back to where we were. Okay, let's go over here to the columns tab. What this tab does is tells the report how it's going to lay out the various columns. Okay, so I'm going to pop over here for a second. So you can see the first column here, column one is the account groups, okay, or accounts. And then you've got balances here in the next three columns. Okay, so column one, two, three, and four. So let's come over here. You can see up here, the columns are listed. So column one, we're telling the report we want to show the account name. Column two, we want actual amounts. Here is where you tell it, do I want it, what period? So do I want current month? This one is current month minus one period. So we're in the February month right now in the system. This one would be January, and then this one would be December. Okay. Now the column headers here for column heading one and two tell the system period name and period date. So it's going to throw that period name and date up here. Okay. And you can scroll down and see, you know, the various other options, and you can come in here and play with, you know, do I want to expand my columns a bit? So it would go this way. Do I want to do different things with totaling? Do I want to total these 3 months? So right here would be this, the total area. Okay. And, you know, if you have accrual versus cash, you can tell it which one to use, but mostly that's just accrual. And you can see some various other highlighting things you can do, visual indicators. You can then hide columns. Say you don't want to show it for some reason when you run this month. You don't, maybe you don't want to show December. You can hide the column here. Say you don't want to delete it, you just want to hide it for a minute. Okay, so you can come in here and adjust various different options, and then just come in here and preview the live report and see what it does. Kind of helps as you're going through and building it, kind of to step it out, preview it, see how you like the rows. Go ahead and preview it, then work with the columns, you know, so it's really user-friendly. As you go through, if you like your progress, save it in between up here. Okay. Okay, now I'm going to come over to the format tab over here. And here you can tell the system what you want the report to do as far as how you treat negatives. Maybe you want some black and red on for negative numbers. Maybe you want red instead of black. If you want rounding or not, if you want the currency symbol, how you want that aligned, and various different formatting options. You can also copy formatting from another report, so you don't have to redo this all the time. Now up here on page setup and columns, you can come up here and you can tell the system Do you want the report title a little bit bigger, the company name, you know, how you want to treat the different items listed here. And various different, if you just keep scrolling down, you can see various different ways you can use the fonts and colors to make it a little more easy to read. Sometimes the titles being bigger is a little bit easier. If you want bold or italics, you know, different sizes, etc. Same with rows and totals over here. Okay. The rest of the tabs over here are, you can add a notation to the balance sheet, you know, at the bottom or somewhere that says, you know, gives a note on that report. You can do permissions. You know, you may only want certain people to be able to see this report in Sage Intacct. So you can do that here. Okay. Some more advanced writing with financial reports. That'll be in another class. But we'll do some computations, some different things in here. But the gist of how to edit and come in here and play with the rows and columns, the format, and how you want it to be detailed and summarized is, you know, coming in here to the rows and columns and using the various options in here. For example, like I covered on the rows here, coming in here and playing with these different levels. Okay. Like I said, you want to come up here and preview it. And then as you like it, come up here and save as you make progress. So you can always get back out and come back into the report if you, you know, mess it up as you're going along and kind of want to go back to that good starting point. So look for a more detailed class on the financial report writing, but here was just a quick overview of how you can get in and use and edit your financial reports.